Can this give traditional cheese a run for its money?
Creamy Camembert that hasn't used milk from a cow, slaughter-free steaks, and chicken breasts grown from cells.
All that's been promised for a while now, a food revolution. Not only would it be free of animal cruelty, it would also help solve the environmental crisis by reducing the amount of land, water, and grain we need to feed animals for our food.
Some countries and US states have even preemptively banned it, concerned it could phase out traditional agriculture. But that's kind of the point. The livestock industry accounts for a fairly large share of the world's greenhouse gas emissions.
We are running on a highway to heaven, yeah?
Lab-grown products could put us on the road to redemption. But how are they made, and when will they actually hit our supermarket shelves?
This place, Formo, is as modern and trendy as you'd expect from a Berlin startup. The only difference here is that instead of brewing beer, they're brewing cheese.
Formo is the brainchild of Rafa Wolgensinger. He wants to be at the forefront of a food revolution, which is no easy task.
Changing food is always like multi-layered in a sense because it's so deeply ingrained in our culture and who we are.
Formo ferment their cheeses with whey-like proteins in a traditional cheese factory, and they've just started selling them within Germany. Then there's cultured meat grown from animal cells. The Israeli firm Aleph Farms say their beefsteaks are close to being rolled out.
Yes, our product is ready to go. The quality and the level of sensory properties, meaning taste, flavor and texture, is today very high.
To be honest, it feels like we've been here before. So what's different now?
The first cultured meat arrived in the form of a burger back in 2013, but the costs were eye-watering rather than mouth-watering. Then came the wave of plant-based vegan cheese and fake meats. They sold pretty well initially, though some big brands have experienced a downturn in sales in 2024.
But none of that has dented the world's appetite for meat and dairy, as consumption continues to grow across the planet.
As parts of the world increase their financial standing, they're also increasing their meat intake, though data does show the Western world is still culpable for the lion's share.
In the Western world, we have to remember that and shift again to a situation where we eat more plant-based food.
That's Thilo Hoon, a food tech professor at the Zurich University of Applied Sciences. He believes plant-based alternatives are a good addition to the food industry, but admits they don't seem to have convinced everyone.
If Elvis Presley steps in the door, I know that this is not Elvis. It could be that he performs even as good as Elvis, but I know it couldn't be that Elvis stands in my office.
It's got to feel like I'm not limiting, I'm not making a sacrifice. We need to get the ones who say, you know, I just want to have great freaking food.
Instead of using oils or nuts to replicate the fat from milk, Formo has focused on creating proteins which mimic whey and use that in a traditional cheese-making process. The taste test is coming up, but first let's dive into why this quest to find alternatives exists in the first place. Just how much the livestock industry contributes to climate warming greenhouse gases depends on who you ask. The UN Food and Agriculture Organization's most recent report cited 12%, but other studies suggest figures as high as 20%. Whatever the number, climate scientists consider methane emissions particularly concerning. They can be 80 times more harmful in terms of heating the atmosphere than CO2. And livestock accounts for about 30% of the world's methane emissions, largely through cow burps. Deforestation, land and water use, and livestock feed are also major concerns.
It's not only the production of meat, it's the overall production of food loss and food waste in the whole system, and the overuse of the resources. It makes more sense to produce plants and eat it directly than to feed it to animals.
An early study by Oxford University in 2011 reported cultivated meat could produce up to 96% fewer greenhouse gas emissions than livestock, thanks to using less land, water, and feed. But the numbers here are also contested. Some studies claim cultivated meat and dairy will need to be run on renewable energy sources if they are to retain lower emissions.
So we know the world needs to change something about its eating habits, but that taste and texture of meat and dairy is something that many people are unwilling to give up, no matter the cost.
To come closer to actual dairy, FORMO uses what's called precision fermentation, the evolution of a process dating back thousands of years. They take koji, a type of fungi which is used a lot in Japanese cuisine, feed and ferment it to create a protein similar to whey, and then turn it into cheese. The company also plans on using an animal-free casein protein, but that first needs EU approval.
A product like cheese, where, you know, it is already a processed product when you start with milk, that there is a fermentation process already involved in the regular production of the product. There, I think it's easier to say, hey, there's just another fermentation step before that, to kind of get people to convert in that sense.
The holy trinity is probably taste, texture, and then cost. We'll get to cost in a moment, but maybe we should just dig straight in and see.
Let's do it.
See how we go with the taste and texture. So that's like a fish kid, a better version of cream cheese.
Correct. Yeah. Correct. Mm. Yeah, you see that? Really creamy.
That's actually pretty good.
Right.
Yeah.
Then we have a Greek feta cheese.
So this one, I'd say the texture is a little bit still like away from like what you would expect from the feta.
Yeah.
But the taste, like the saltiness and everything, it's really there.
Then we have a brie, like white mold cheese, fresh cheese.
Yeah. The texture is 100% there with the creaminess. That texture is a lot better than some breeze that I buy in the supermarket.
Yeah.
So the cheese checks out, but what about that third component in the holy trinity, price? Rafa says it will initially be 10 to 20% more expensive than mid-range cheese. So we're still talking luxury prices for most people, but it's not outrageously expensive either. And Rafa claims FORMO's cheese will eventually sell for cheaper than traditional dairy.
Fermentation is just more efficient with resources than animals. Much more efficient, actually. The question of the cost and the price pretty much is only a factor of scale.
All right, that's the cheese. But what about that highly sought-after steak? There are quite a few companies out there working on cultured meat, from beef to chicken to fish to foie gras. Aleph Farms is just one of a handful that already have approval to sell their lab-grown meat, in their case, in Israel. The company said they will roll out within the next year, but admitted it will be a luxury item to begin with, sold in high-end restaurants at a price similar to premium range beef.
It might take 10 years to get to the mainstream market. It will not happen overnight, just because it takes time to build production capacity, to drive the cost down, to build the supply chain.
Studies show customers are still skeptical about how this alternative meat is made. Aleph Farms say they are following the same basic principles of fermentation, only they start with animal cells, feed and nurture them in a bioreactor until they replicate only the edible part of animals.
We do eat cells from cows when we eat meat products. So that's the same cells, the same ancient time-honored cell cultivation technique, and we just merge the two to make a new combination. And the cells we use are not genetically engineered.
The quest to develop the perfect steak or the creamiest camembert is, of course, just half the battle. Because before these products have even hit the shelves, they're receiving a lot of blowback behind the scenes.
Italy's parliament moved to ban the production, sale or import of cultivated meat and animal feed in 2023. The US states of Florida and Alabama followed suit with their own bans in 2024.
I love that they banned it, because that shows it's real. Why would you ban something that you don't believe is going to become relevant in the marketplace? So it's also a great signal, I think, that says like, damn, big meat is really concerned with this. The farming lobby is really concerned about that.
The reasoning from politicians is that traditional agriculture has to be protected.
This stance of, you know, allegedly protecting you know, the traditional agriculture is also selling very well, you know, in terms of elections, you know, even beyond the farming industry. You know, a lot of people, you know, are connected emotionally to agriculture and to traditional agriculture.
The transition away from traditional agriculture is clearly a sensitive topic. It's estimated that 857 million people worldwide work in the industry, which is why many countries subsidise farming. The EU will provide about 387 billion euros in agricultural policy funds between 2021 and 2027.
You're obviously playing on a completely uneven playing ground. I'm not even arguing for we need support to lower, you know, the price of our products. I'm not even arguing for products who emit a lot of emissions need to be priced harder. I'm just saying, you know, give everybody the same. And then, you know, I have full conviction that this technology is more efficient. It will be, you know, cheaper and it performs great. And consumers will make the choice is based on that.
This all comes as traditional agriculture is facing major issues, as we covered in this report. In the EU, just 12% of farm managers are under the age of 40, with almost 60% age 55 or above, meaning many could retire in the next decade. Climate change is also already affecting livestock farms. Those in Sicily, for example, are struggling amid prolonged drought and record high temperatures.
This is also one area where FORMO is conscious of finding solutions which combine the old with the new.
We're speaking with the traditional dairy and farming industry, because also in this technology, it's not like, you know, farming, traditional farming as we know it, won't play any role anymore. You know, to do that, to grow proteins in a fermentation tank and to produce these products, you need nutrients. Nutrients are coming from our fields. So you will always have, you know, traditional farming as you know it.
Cultured meat is still some way away from being a legitimate alternative for the mainstream. But FORMO has just shown me that animal-free cheese is here. It may not compare to the best BO French cheese you've ever had in your life, but it definitely rivals those found in German supermarkets.
Of course, simply eating more beans and veg is another way of substituting animal products, and the market for these animal-free alternatives is still very small. But if they can convince consumers' taste buds and bank balances, more people may jump on board, which can only be good news for the world's climate.
Would you tuck into lab-grown food? Let us know in the comments below. And if you want to see more videos like this on Planet A, give us a like and a subscribe. We have a new video out every Friday.